the way I had a chance to see the other day, and she's a fine pitcher, but he wasn't seeing enough of the games. Jay was a reporter for 21 years before coming to the White House, including a stint as Moscow bureau chief for Time magazine during the collapse of the Soviet Empire. So he comes to this place with a reporter's perspective. That's why, believe it or not, I actually think he will miss hanging out with all of you, including the guys in the front row. Jay has become one of my closest friends and is a great press secretary and a great advisor. He's got good judgment, he has good temperament, and he's got a good heart. And I'm going to miss him a lot. I will continue to rely on him as a friend and advisor after he leaves to spend as much of the summer as he can with his kids before he decides what's next for him, whatever it is. I know he's going to be outstanding at it. Of course, that meant I had to make a decision, which is who succeeds Jay. And we've got enormous talent around here, but I've decided that we're going to put in this slot somebody who is also a friend and advisor. So today, the flak jacket is officially passed to a new generation, Mr. Josh Earnest. Josh is a coach's son from Kansas City. He still roots for the Royals, I guess. As you know, his name describes his demeanor. Josh is an earnest guy, and you can't find just a nicer individual, even outside of Washington. The country, of course, knows him for his golden voice and dulcet tones on West Wing Week, the biggest viral internet hit since Between Two Ferns. But Josh and I have an incredible history going all the way back to the Iowa caucuses. Josh was my Iowa communications director, and even when he was in that role, you'd find him spending an extra hour or two helping young staffers make phone calls or knock on doors. There was no task that was too small, no detail too unimportant for Josh to attend to. At the White House, he's been a mentor to many of the young people here who I know are thrilled for him today. He is of sound judgment and great temperament. He is honest and full of integrity. And I'm sure you will at some point get frustrated with him as well. But it's going to be hard because he's a straight shooter and a great guy. So my request is that be nice to Jay on his farewell tour and be nice to Josh during his initiation, which I'm sure will last maybe 2 days or perhaps two questions. So. We're going to let him hang around a little bit to milk it for all it's worth. All right? Thank you, guys.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Yep. Any questions?
Where do we start? What is the timeline, Jay? Yeah, do you have a sense?
We haven't got a date set. Part of his penance or initiation will be that Josh will go to Europe in my stead. Thank you, sir. Which will allow me a little time here when the boss is gone. But I'm looking at mid-June, second or third week around then.
So. And what are you going to do? Are you going to join any bands or anything?
Well, I might manage my son's band, which is on the verge of taking off. But I haven't made any decisions yet. I've managed over the past months to have some conversations about what my future might look like, and I'm excited by some of the possibilities. But I'm sure you guys will be among the first to know once I've I've decided what I'm going to do. But, you know, I will, before, let me, I'm happy to talk about myself, of course, but the, I will, this is not my last briefing, and I will probably have a few more polished things to say at some point before I go. But I, off the cuff, I obviously just want to thank the President, the Vice President, First Lady, and Dr. Biden, the Chiefs of Staff I have had the privilege to work with, including Dennis McDonough, and everyone here. But there'll be another time for more of that. But it's been an amazing experience, just so fulfilling. And I said, as we surprised some folks in here in the minutes before I came out, that probably the best part about it is that in midlife, you don't often make a whole new set of friends, and not just friends, but people you would fight by and for under any circumstance, and that's certainly what I have been lucky enough to get over these past 5.5 years. So it's been a privilege, and it continues to be a privilege, and every day in here with you has been a privilege. People,
every day?
More often than not, say to me, you have the hardest job, or you have one of the hardest jobs, and I'm not saying it's easy every day, but I love it. It's an important interaction that takes place here. It's not always pretty. It could certainly be better, but it's to be a part of it is an honor and a joy for me. So, and no matter how tough the briefing is, I walk out of here having been glad to stand here. So with that, like I said, I'll take more questions and talk about me, but I can also take questions on other subjects if you so desire.
You want to dispel the Moscow ambassador rumors?
Yes, I can assure you that my family, having won me back, would not be happy with that outcome. So I am not.
No jobs in government.
That, I would not anticipate that. Anybody else? April? Yes, ma'am.
Jay, since you've been here in the White House in various capacities, and in this business, broadcasting business in various capacities, what have you learned through your stint being here in these seats, when it used to look another way, and then over there, and then over here in the administrative capacity? What have you learned, and what could you tell us to be able to better work with you as we continue our job as you will?
April, I don't think I want to have everybody sit here and hear me opine or on this subject at length now, but I'm sure we'll be seeing each other both in this room and elsewhere over the next couple of weeks and beyond. And I'll have a few things to say about how I view this job and the interaction that takes place in here and just around this building and this town. And hopefully some of the things I say will resonate somewhere, but I don't think today's the day. I think today I want to just focus on how pleased I am that Josh is going to succeed me, and how very honored I feel still to have had this job.
Thank